So you talked about sifting through information. I think in this age is absolutely, it's a challenge. It's its own piece of work. So how do you approach that? There's so much. We're not even talking about necessarily what is and isn't true that it's sort of is brought out, but there's so much information to ingest for you just to catch up, you know, and people, it's a tough thing, you know. It's you can't have a hobby; you have to have a full time commitment in these days. Which and the amount of time in anyone's life has maintained itself to be 24 hours in a day, unfortunately. So how do you manage that? How do you you know, and you know, with all these newsletters and all that, but these are really just links for you to keep going and learning more, which is fine. But if you just still, again, don't have that much time. So how do you are you able to stay up to date, especially with, you know, a lab? Or not, I think you were sort of, you pushed back on the idea that it is a lab, but I guess a responsibility to manage as well and still keep up to date, right?
I mean, I try to be realistic and also focused on the innovation that I really care about. So there are a few topics that I want to follow more closely. That's around the science of generative AI, that is around orchestration of AI application, user experiences. Anything else, I don't have the bandwidth to go after. So I think staying disciplined is basically what helps. And when I look for good aggregator sources, things like surveys or meetups or conferences, I think those tend to be places where you get good summaries brought to you, and that allows you to also cover any blank spots that you have in your investigation,
in your knowledge base. I'm kind of surprised you talked about conferences as a place where a lot of information is shared for you and has a lot of value for you. What is it about having those conferences that you know? Is it that there tend to be newer? Is tends to be newer information that comes through, or it's just like?
I think it's a breadth. Like I typically tend to go to. When I talk about conferences, I'm talking a little bit more scientific than even sort of like a Western thing, which can become quite salesy.
Yeah, it's a performance a little bit. It's a show.
Exactly to your point. I think these other conferences, they bring the latest innovation, but they also bring in diversity. If they are large enough, there are 5 or 6 large teams that each of these events tackle. And each of those type of venues also have a slightly different focus. Some are like very theoretical, some are very applied, and some in between. Some are NLP focus, some are computer vision focus, some are more application agnostic ML focus. So you can mix and match, and you get, I would say, the two things. Like, one is the latest, the state of the art, but also diversity. And that both are important. So
in subject matter.
Yeah.
Right. So if a young person was trying to get into the field, how would you, and especially, you know, these things change all the time, but what would you say is the most interesting part of AI that you've seen so far? Obviously, generative AI, generally speaking. But what is it that, you know, maybe needs the most work and has the most blue ocean to you know, to swim in and find innovation? So what do you think that is?
I think AI is, I would say, right now, just at the cusp of impacting our entire life. Right? I think what you're seeing is now more like eye-catchy type of application. What I'm excited about are things like healthcare and biotech. I read recently a report that about 30% of world's data is generated in that space. But if you look at the amount of innovation from a technology perspective that has happened, that's big tally. So that's a ripe area. But even other places, like for example, the the way we are interacting right now, that also feels a little clunky, the current world. Like, how do you make this more seamless, and how do you help people, as we also talked about at the beginning, how do you help people stay organized? How do you support people in their work? Work and life is also blurring, and people have needs that for that to be blending seamlessly. Like, how do you support those? So there's, I think, in the, what you might see in the next couple of years are these first type of applications that happen. And then if you're interested in research in this field, I would say the science of understanding how these work and why hallucinations or fabrications happen, I think those are pretty rich areas to explore. Another one is how do you mitigate biases in these systems? How do you, there's a lot of talk in the media responsible AI, but that's really overloaded talk, or breaking down into things like interpretability, things like fairness, things like deep biasing. And lastly, you know, a new area that has come up, which didn't exist before, is like, how do you make this AI system secure? So we talk about what can AI do for you? But the converse is also important, like, how do you prevent these systems from being jailbroken? How do you prevent prompt injection attacks or safeguard against prompt injection attacks? So there's I think those are just beginning to get explored. So I think there's the next, say, 2 to 5 years, I would see those as good opportunities to invest yourself in.
The healthcare is very compelling. The healthcare angle is very compelling. 30% of data is in healthcare, and it's not being touched.
The percentage of GDP that Western world devotes to healthcare, it is just upside down the Western world, because the issue on the global south is just catching up to reaching on one same level. So ultimately, the whole world will need these type of investments. And yet, the general perception is effectiveness is far below what seems needed or desirable. What's the role that AI can play? Again, AI is often thought as a new tool, as opposed to what I would advocate is use AI to take a fresh look at the problem. Not as like, okay, there are like 7 steps to the problem, I can use AI to solve like step 6 or step 7. I think that's where currently you find a lot of frustration with AI innovation. People try this out, they find for the cost of investment, it's not as valuable. So there's a lot of excitement, but there is also some quickly building
and pullback. All right. So the AI security problem too attaches to that, you know, because it is, you know, there's a personal data that in a way, when people use AI, they're going to use it very personally because it interfaces very personally. And so the security problem becomes a little bit higher. And the accuracy problem still needs to be solved as well. So there are actually quite some fundamental issues that a person can come in and really contribute to. But it is very exciting.
If you like what you saw, take a look at the description. You'll see segments. You'll see the full podcast. Go take a look. Please go listen. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. We'll see you later.